Now the second transformation of axis is rotation of axis. Now in this transformation, what we generally do is we keep the origin same and we just rotate the axis. Now say for example, suppose we have a system whose axis are x and y. Now keeping the origin same, suppose we have rotated the axis by some angle, say alpha. And say this angle is alpha and it is in the anti-clockwise direction. Now in this new system, which is say x dash and y dash, we need to find coordinate of any point P. There are many ways to solve these problems, but generally we use three common methods. Now the first method is to use formulas. Suppose we have any point, say P, whose coordinate is say x and y. Now let distance from origin be r and this angle be theta. Now in the coordinate system xy, we can write x as r cos theta and we can write y as r sin theta. So this distance, it is r cos theta, and this distance is r sin theta, and therefore we have x as r cos theta and y as r sin theta. Now in this new system, which is x dash or y dash, this angle will now be theta minus alpha. So now we look for this distance. So this distance here, it will be r cos theta minus alpha, and it'll be equal to its new coordinate, which is x dash and y dash. So x dash is r cos theta minus alpha, and in the same way we can write y dash as r sine theta minus alpha. Now this is r. Now cos a minus b is cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. So we can write this as x dash r cos theta into cos alpha plus r sin theta into sin alpha. Now r cos theta is x and r sin theta is y. So we can simply write x dash as x cos alpha plus y sin alpha. Now in the same way, we'll simplify this y dash. We can write y dash as r sin theta cos alpha minus r cos theta sin alpha. So again, r sin theta is y. So it'll be y cos alpha minus x sin alpha. So if we rotate the axis by an angle alpha in anti-clockwise direction, then the coordinate of the point, which was x comma y, will now transform to x cos alpha plus y sin alpha and y cos alpha minus x sin alpha. So that is the coordinate in this new system x dash o y dash. So the result that we have here is x dash will be x cos alpha plus y sin alpha, and y dash will be y cos alpha minus x sin alpha. Now if we have to write the new equation, then we need to write x and y in terms of x dash and y dash. Now solving these two equations, we can simply write x as x dash cos alpha minus y dash sin alpha, and we can write y as y dash cos alpha plus x dash sin alpha. So we need to remember these two results. To find coordinate of the points, we'll use this first formula, and to find equation of the curve in the new system, we'll use this second formula. The method that I like the most is complex number method. So suppose we have this axis, say x, y and o, and suppose we have any point P, which is x comma y. Now again, suppose this distance is r and this is theta. So we can write a complex number z as x plus iota y, and which is r e to the power iota theta. Now suppose we take another set of axes which makes an angle alpha with the given axis, keeping the origin same. And suppose this alpha is in anti-clockwise direction. Now in this new coordinate system, this x dash will be simply x dash plus iota y dash, and we can write this as r e to the power iota. Now this angle is simply theta minus alpha, so it will be simply e to the power iota theta minus alpha. So we can write z dash as r e to the power iota theta into e to the power minus iota alpha. So z dash will be, so r into e to the power iota theta is simply z, and then e to the power minus iota alpha. So this is the relationship between the two given coordinates. So we can write x dash plus iota y dash is equal to x plus iota y, and it'll simply be e to the power minus iota alpha. So we'll simplify this result. We can write x plus iota y, and this one is cos alpha minus iota sine alpha. So then we can write x dash plus iota y dash. So it'll be x cos alpha, and then minus minus it'll be plus, plus y sine alpha, and plus iota it'll be y cos alpha minus x sine alpha. So we'll compare. We can simply write x dash as x cos alpha plus y sine alpha, and we can write y dash as y cos alpha minus x sine alpha. So this is how we can write coordinate in the new system. Now suppose we have to write x plus iota y in terms of x dash and y dash, then we can simply write x plus iota y is equal to x dash plus iota y dash into e to the power I alpha. So what we have done is we have taken this e to the power minus I alpha on the left hand side. Then we can write x plus iota y, and this is x dash plus iota y dash, and will be cos alpha plus iota sine alpha. So we'll compare its real part, then we can get x dash cos alpha minus y dash sine alpha, and we can write y as y dash cos alpha plus x dash sine alpha. So this is our second method to write formulas for rotation of axis. And the third method is simply matrix method. In the matrix method, we can write these new coordinates x dash y dash as x cos alpha plus y sine alpha. So it will be cos alpha sine alpha, and here it will be minus sine alpha and cos alpha. So it will be minus sine alpha and cos alpha, and we'll multiply it with x y. So we'll multiply this matrix, then we can write x cos alpha plus y sine alpha, and that is x dash. If we'll multiply the second row, then we'll get minus x sine alpha plus y cos alpha, and that's your y dash. If you want to remember a simple formula, then I think matrix method is the simplest method. So all you need to do is you'll just need to remember this matrix, which is cos alpha sine alpha minus sine alpha and cos alpha. Now if we'll find inverse of this matrix, suppose this is A. Now determinant of A is 1, adjoint of A simply will be interchange A and D, so it'll be cos alpha, and then it'll be minus B minus C, so it'll be minus sine alpha, and then sine alpha. Now we'll divide adjoint with determinant, which is 1, then it'll become A inverse. So if we have to write x, y in terms of x dash and y dash, then it'll simply be x, y, and there'll be cos alpha minus sine alpha cos alpha into x dash y dash. Now we'll multiply, we'll get x dash cos alpha minus y dash sine alpha. So x dash cos alpha minus y dash sine alpha, and here will be x dash sine alpha plus y dash cos alpha. So x dash sine alpha plus y dash cos alpha. So this is third method to remember these formulas. Now let us take one example. Say for example, suppose we have point P which is given by 2 comma 3 root 2. Now keeping the origin same, suppose axes are rotated by an angle pi by 4 in the anti-clockwise direction, then we'll need to find the coordinate of this point P in the new system. Now, if we'll do it with complex number method, we know that z dash is z into e to the power minus iota alpha. So, it'll be z dash and then it'll be 2 plus 3 root 2 iota and then e to the power minus iota pi by 4. So, there'll be z dash and it'll be 2 plus 3 root 2 iota and it'll be cos pi by 4, which is 1 by root 2, and minus iota sin pi by 4, it'll be minus 1 by root 2. So, this z dash will be, what is the real part? It'll be 2 upon root 2 and then minus minus plus 3 root 2 upon root 2 and then plus, what is the imaginary part? Imaginary part is 3 root 2 upon root 2 minus 2 upon root 2. So, this z dash will be root 2 plus 3 plus iota 3 minus root 2. So, in the new coordinate system, the coordinate of this point P will be 3 plus root 2 and 3 minus root 2. If you want to solve the same question using matrix method, then we can simply write x dash y dash and this is equal to cos alpha sin alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha, and here it will be xy. So cos alpha, it is 1 by root 2, sin alpha 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2, and this again is 1 by root 2. Now what's x and y? X here is 2 and y here is 3 root 2. Now we'll multiply these two matrices, then it'll simply be, so it'll be 2 upon root 2 plus 3 root 2 upon root 2, and here it will be minus 2 upon root 2 plus 3 root 2 upon root 2. So this is nothing but this is root 2 plus 3 and here it is minus root 2 plus 3. So again x is 3 plus root 2 and y is 3 minus root 2. Now again in this there will be questions on the new equation of the curve in the new coordinate system when the axes are rotated. Now say for example, suppose we are given a curve which is x square plus 2 root 3 xy minus y square and this is equal to 2a square. Now it says the axes are rotated by an angle theta which is 30 degrees in the anticlockwise direction. Find the new equation. So if we'll use matrix method, we can write xy as cos alpha minus sine alpha cos alpha, and it'll be x dash y dash. So we can write this is cos alpha. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2 and sin 30 is 1 by 2. So it'll be 1 by 2 and then again it'll be root 3 by 2 and here we have x dash and y dash. Now we'll multiply it. We can write x y as root 3 x dash minus y dash upon 2. And here it will be x dash plus root 3 y dash upon 2. Now we'll replace x and y. So we'll put the value of x here. We'll write root 3 x dash minus y dash by 2 whole square plus 2 root 3 root 3 x dash minus y dash by 2 into x dash plus root 3 y dash by 2 and minus it is x dash plus root 3 y dash by 2 whole square and this is equal to 2a square. Now we can simplify this as 3 x dash square plus y dash square minus 2 root 3 x dash y dash upon 4 plus 2 root 3 and then will be root 3 x dash square plus 3 x dash y dash minus x dash y dash minus root 3 y dash square upon 4, and then minus will be x dash square plus 3 y dash square plus 2 root 3 x dash y dash upon 4, and this is equal to 2 a square. Now we have 3 x dash square, here it will be 6 x dash square and then minus x dash square, so there will be 8 x dash square, and then it is y dash square minus 6 y dash square and minus 3 y dash square, so it will be minus 8 y dash square. Now it will be minus 6 root 3 x dash y dash, here it will be 6 root 3 x dash y dash, and then minus 2 root 3 x dash y dash plus 2 root x dash y dash, so it will cancel. So this divided by 4 is equal to 2 a square. So the new equation simply will be x dash square minus y dash square is equal to a square. So if the axes are rotated by an angle 30 degrees in the anticlockwise direction, then the new equation of this curve will be x square minus y square is equal to a square. Another question is, suppose we are given the equation which is x square minus y square is equal to a square, and suppose the axes are now rotated by an angle pi by 4 in the anticlockwise direction, we have to find new equation of this curve. Now we know that we can write x, y as cos alpha, which is 1 by root 2, minus sin alpha, and then sin alpha and cos alpha, and this is x dash y dash. So we'll multiply, then we can simply compare, then we can simply write x as x dash minus y dash by root 2, and in the same way we can write y as x dash plus y dash by root 2. Now we'll put the value of x and y, so here it will be x dash minus y dash whole square by 2 minus x dash plus y dash whole square by 2, and it is equal to a square. Now x square y square will cancel, so it will be minus 4 x dash y dash, and it is equal to 2 a square. So the new equation will be x dash y dash is equal to minus a square upon 2, which is a rectangular hyperbola.